About this review. I, Daniel Bader, have been using the Galaxy S8 and Galaxy S8 Plus at different times for a total of 2 weeks, spanning New York, New York, and Toronto, Ontario. Both models are unlocked Canadian models connected to AT&T in the US or Rogers in Canada, with Snapdragon 835 processors and Sony IMX camera sensors. One day prior to the review embargo, Samsung released a small update for the Galaxy S8 and S8 Plus, updating the software to build G950 WVLU1AQD9. The update prepared the units for Bixby Voice, which still doesn't work, and updated the security patch to April 1, 2017. It also closed the loophole to allow remapping of the Bixby button. A Fitbit Alta HR was connected to the phones during the review period. The main takeaway here, and the reason we feel comfortable combining the two phones into a single review, is because, unlike their predecessors, the S8 and S8 Plus are merely two sizes, and even then, aren't that drastically different. The Galaxy S8 is 5.8 inches, with a new 18:5:9 aspect ratio. The S8 Plus is 6.2 inches, which makes it a bit taller and slightly wider, with a battery 16% larger. Since 2016, Samsung has built its flagship phones with aluminum frames and glass fronts and backs. And as good as the Galaxy S6 series was, the refinement in this year's phones is noticeable. The curved glass front meets the metal frame at the same gradual angle as the back, which maintains symmetry that debuted on the Note 7, but here looks even better. Part of that comes down to Samsung's color choices: color-matched metal around the midnight black mod. The corners curve, the display curves, the glass curves. This is a phone that has no sharp corners, nowhere to focus our attention away from the massive screen. If you think back to the proposition of the Galaxy S3, all the way back in 2012, Samsung wanted the focus on its pebble design and nature UX. This phone, 5 years later, is the culmination of that journey, for better or worse. That shape and choice of materials also lends the phone an unprecedented slipperiness. You probably shouldn't try to nestle the Galaxy S8 in the crook of your neck while you're talking on the phone. After a few hours, sometimes a few minutes, even the phone will be fingerprint smudged and slippery, so if you're clumsy, you will probably want to invest in a case, or a microfiber cloth. That screen, the so-called Infinity Display, is not a huge departure from something like the Galaxy S7's Edge, but it eliminates as much of the bezels above and below the display as possible. LG did it first with the G6, well, Xiaomi did it with the Mi Mix, and Huawei has been inching towards it for years, but this is a truly remarkable achievement nonetheless.